Were you dumbfounded by this decision?
Was I dumbfounded that New York politicians were going to ruin it for everybody? No. Was it an exhausting day yesterday? Yes. I'm actually surprised you convinced me to be here. It was a lot. We put, I think, 15 different apartments into contracts, purely speculative based on the Amazon move in November, and all 15 of those buyers called yesterday.
Right.
Freaking out, saying, can I pull my deposit? So, can I get it back? Is there an Amazon contingency in my contract? I didn't even read the contract, Ryan. What do we do? Right.
And I'm like, whoa. I don't know if I'm sympathetic for those folks, but what I want to understand just about Long Island City, because we're gonna have another guest on, the man who effectively killed this deal, in the next hour.
Can I stay for that?
You can. And he's gonna say that there are cranes all over Long Island City, that it is a bustling, thriving environment that did not need Amazon, and that even without Amazon, everything is gonna be more than fine. And
yeah,
so I wanna understand
whatever.
From you, you're saying whatever. So yeah. Tell us.
I mean, that's like going back a couple hundred years ago and looking at New York City and that part of the city as a farm and saying, you know what? This area is bustling. Look at him over there. Everything's good. Stop with the industrialization. Like, let's go back in time. I want that guy to come in here, and I'd like to stay for
that
guy.
Can I ask what your political leanings are?
Sure. I'm independent. I mean, I would like there to be as much growth for the locals here and for the international community who loves New York City and who loves the education system and who loves our infrastructure as possible. And Amazon coming, I think, was a great thing. I mean, all they wanted to do was bring jobs at the end of the day. They wanted to bring jobs. They wanted to bring 25,000 jobs. They wanted to spend billions of dollars here. And over the course of time, they wanted to spend billions of dollars in taxes.
Good job.
But it was a compromise. It was a deal.
What do you think the ramifications are long term when you think about other business owners, executives who are thinking about either locating in New York or expanding in New York? Do you think this will have an impact, or do you think this is a blip along the?
It's at the end of the day, it will be a blip. But what I think it'll do that'll be good is I've always loved Long Island City. I think it's a great place for real estate investment. Like we said, I started my career there. I was taking the 7 train from 42nd Street to Long Island City every single day in 2008 and 2009 when the market totally crashed in New York City because everybody said, I don't know what to do with my money. I don't want to rent. Where can I go get great value? There's this place called Long Island City. I only know it because of the PepsiCo sign.
But a big part of GNRS's argument to Andrew earlier this week was that subway line that you're talking about is already overtaxed. And this is true from, you know, people in Queens, they have leaflets out, 3, 4, 5 leaflets per household all over the borough, not even in that immediate area.
Sure.
The locals feel like it's going to ruin the subway system. They don't want the development. There's a big NIMBY aspect of this, right?
Yeah.
What could have been done to better sell them on this being long-term good for the community, short-term bad?
I didn't stop New York City from creating the extension of the Q line up 2nd Avenue. Like, we didn't get rid of the Upper East Side. Everything is gonna be okay. And listen, I remember doing deals at $600 a square foot in Long Island City in 2009, and everyone was so angry about it. They're never gonna get their money back. Oh my goodness, what are we gonna do? And I just resold an apartment that I sold for $900,000 in 2009 in October, so before the Amazon announcement, for $1.8 million.
Okay, so who really gets hurt there? I mean, Andrew said we don't have a lot of sympathy for people, but there are a lot of companies and people who bet on this.
Sure.
Who gets hurt, and what are your senses of how much people might lose in the short term? Because they really were betting on this $25,000.
I mean, listen, anyone who's in the real estate business understands that the definition of a boom is a sharp increase from a normal, and booms oftentimes can go bust. But I think the developers and the institutional investors who bought up land in order to build rental buildings for 25,000 strong, smart workers who are making good incomes, those people are going to now have to find new people to rent to. But that's going to happen. It's going to be okay because now there's all this space that Amazon isn't going to fill. New companies are going to come in. It's going to be great.
So here's the question. You know, this morning, all the papers are giving, you know, our prime suspect had an axe to grind with Governor Cuomo. The idea being that these political leaders, are going to be a blowback against these political leaders for pushing Amazon out. On the other end, people like AOC and GNRS are claiming this as victory.
Sure.
2 years from now, when there's going to be elections for people like this, will voters in Long Island City say, you represented my constituency well, I'm glad you did this, and our economy is doing just fine, thank you?
Mm-hmm.
Or are they going to say, man, was this one of the great mistakes of all time?
Unfortunately, I think it will be the former. And I don't think that that's right. I think that the Amazon boom, as we can call it, happened too quickly. And no one was really able to understand the benefits that that many jobs to the area would have brought to the locals.
I think that's sinking in right now, that they're really gone and it really is 25,000. And I would look at it not just as the Long Island city politicians.
State of New York.
Even beyond that, I look at this as sort of pulling back the facade or the curtain on Liz Warren. I do. And this is what you get when you don't just talk the talk, all these ideas that seem so, that have so much merit, and you actually see the end result of what happens to some of these ideas. I think this is a watershed moment.
But I think that, listen, as far as real estate goes and the real estate investment community and the owners, the families who live in Long Island City with three kids who go to school in the area, Amazon did help us. They put Long Island City on the map as an amazing place to be. And Amazon isn't coming to Long Island City because of Amazon's choice. They wanted to bring a lot of jobs and a lot of money to the area. And New York said, no! We don't want that. We can't. The area is too good already. You're going to crush us.
Is there a risk that now that New York is, quote, closed for business, or there's that perception that the broader New York City real estate market could suffer, especially as we have the SALT deduction issue coming on?
And not just New York City, the entire tri-state area relies on this engine of growth.
Do you feel like this could add some more pressure to a certainly broader New York City market, definitely Manhattan, that's already under some pressure?
I don't think so. I think if anything, it'll maybe make the area a little bit cheaper for other companies to come in, because they're going to say, listen, we could come in, we could pull out too. And you're going to have landlords say, no, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine.
But I can't imagine you'll see any kind of subsidy offer for any big company in the city in the next couple of years as a result of this. No?
If
you're Mayor de Blasio,
but for Queens,
then nobody's coming.
The incentive program offers a couple of $1,000s per head for anybody. Any business automatically qualifies in that area. That incentive program was $1 billion of the $3 billion figure that we're talking about.
Yeah.
And it's available to anyone. Amazon just would have been the biggest to tap it so far.
Yes. And I still think you'll see that. I think more than anything, the exposure has been great. Even right now, like we are sitting here talking about it. It's been a couple minutes. We're still talking about it. And we're talking about Long Island City real estate. When, since November, ever have we spent this much time on television talking about Long Island City real estate?
What about Mayor de Blasio? Is this a win for Mayor de Blasio? Is this a loss for Mayor de Blasio? And remember, he brought them here and then managed, I thought, very strangely yesterday to say, you know, thank you for playing and good luck to you after trying to draw them in, actually hit him on the way out.
De Blasio is an interesting guy. I don't think he necessarily knows exactly what he wants every day. I think he plays to his constituents, and if they like him, he goes with them. If they don't like him, he tries to fix it, and it's unfortunate. But I think that Long Island City will remain strong. I think values have been great, and it's still inexpensive compared to outside here.
What's the average apartment price in LIC versus Manhattan?
It's like couple hundred dollars a foot less than in kind of the average median price in New York
City. Where else other than Manhattan or New York City could de Blasio get elected to anything? And nothing will affect him here. I mean, it's staggering that you've elected him twice already. Okay.
I'm not going to defend the mayor, but I don't know if we can.
But he's very. I mean, he's not your. You have to go. You might have to go all the way to the other coast to get to another place where.
If indulge me for a second, I think we can run a full screen. I just want to tell you about this quote. This is the spokesman for Amazon explaining why they ultimately decided to leave the city. And I just want to get your reaction to this. It's a spokeswoman, I should say. She said, looking at the opposition and the timeline, we decided we don't want to work in this environment in the long run.
Yeah.
Meaning that the environment was so inhospitable to them. The idea that there were going to be people, it'd be like moving into a neighborhood and having a vocal minority of people picketing outside of your house who hate you.
Right.
And who wants to work in an environment where that exists, even if the majority of people, and the poll suggested that the majority of New York wanted them there?
100%. I think the saddest part of all this is how we weren't able to come to some sort of compromise. And it wasn't just a hard set no. It was that we couldn't figure out a way to make a deal work. And that's what real estate deals are all about. Even in speculative markets, it's how can we make this work for everybody?
Though, if the stakeholders in that community felt like they had been more involved in this, wasn't just given to them and said, look, it's done.
Yeah, I think so. If people have gotten together or just come to the table and said, listen, these are our issues. Let's figure out how to make it work. And again, were we in the room? We weren't. But I think when you put great people together and figure out a way to make things better for everybody, instead of just a few people standing on their box saying, no, 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 vote for me because I'm doing what's right for you, even though you don't know what I'm doing, right. then that's where we are in disaster mode.